Bundy will be enforcement officer for this Auckland Native Magistrate Court. I'll explain that shortly, but I want to introduce our panel of judges here today, Native Court judges, in a magistrate court sense of the word when this flag was first commissioned in 1834. On my right side, which is the King side of British, this is British today, and the 1835 on the Queen side, we're joining those two together legally for the very first time in the history of this country to leave all nations, indigenous peoples, on the same pattern of monarchy rule over our lands. And that includes all affected native countries and their tribes watching what's happening here today. So you can pat yourself on the back and be humble and at this point in time to lead off in this process. We have Hiriwini Karaka, 90 years old, war veteran, on the military side of this flag to represent the native here, in a sense Maori on this side, and the original Moriori, Cook Island and Tahitian and Arawa and the rest of the tribes in the Whakapapa here. I'll explain a little later. Hiriwini is our Paramount Chief Justice adjudicating this court hearing today from a legal standpoint of British flag jurisdiction of admiralty that made mortgages and bank loans from the Magistrate Court in Edinburgh to Westminster Magistrate Court to Okiato Magistrate Court in Kororarika in Russell, Fair Islands, to Waitangi Marae Native Magistrate Court, to Titi Marae Native Magistrate Court, to Te Huku o Te Ika Marae Native Magistrate Court, now to Te Unga Waka Marae Native Magistrate Court, in history locked today for the British to take care of the business side of our partnership on the King's side. So on the left side, the Queen, the Maori government with Georgie here, Job and Sue Nakura. I'm familiar, I've got all that information that they have as well from the Confederation of Chiefs is on the left-hand side of the flag that has to address all Tikiriki or Waitangi problems, Treaty of Waitangi 1840 to 1835 period. That's their responsibility in this court hearing today. And then we have Manahi Parapara Mohini of an original Moriori named in Manukau, Tira, Waikato, Whareherehere, Manukau, 1820, signed with Lieutenant William Simons in the Edinburgh Magistrate Court to set the whole native title from that day. Year 1820, cut off to 1834, the 1834 declaration of a war state of emergency flag. This is the Declaration of Independence flag, 1835. This today is the commercial side of the Declaration of War Bank flag that we have to address the urgency. In a sense, it's not a war declaration of war, it's a declaration of financial martial law to make both sides accountable for the land and resources that have been taken for private interest on the side of the royal families and not much left on this side. This is straight up and King contract, and this is Queen and Iwi Maori contract. So that defines who we are here today on this for the people watching around the world today. It has come to this time that we are here in Rio, the people that they've been waiting for in Britain, who they will listen to from legal documents. Here you'll see behind me all the titles of this country, from this Moriori title to 1834 cover on the King's side. And this side is in the real now. They have to address that issue and file it into here straight to Britain. The British, this land has been dormant all along. It's no longer dormant today and from the time we opened the Waikangi Moai Native King's Bench Magistrate Court. So I'll let Bundy have a talk before we proceed with the court hearing.
Tuihia ki te rangi, tuihia ki te whenua, tuihia ke rote te ngākau tangata. Ko te mea nui o tēnei ao, ko te āmpa, ki hei wa Māori ora. E tuaka nei ki te tautoko ngā mihi i mihi ia te ata nei. E te kai karaki e tuku whakawhetai ki te atua ke manaaki tia mai mātou e runga tēnei mahi tino hohunu i roti ia tātou ki tēnei rā. E mihi ana ki tēnei o tātou nei kau mātua mō ana nei oratanga kia kite e pi ao ka eia te tino rangatira i wangini ia tātou me wāna nei mahi i mahingia i roto i ngā hoia 21 taino ki tēnei wā i roto nā ko here uni karata tēnei me ngā mahi o tēnei o tāta nei rangatire o hakahaere ana wēnei kōrero e pāna ki o māta nei taitara ki tā māta nei whenua i roto i ngā ture o te kingi Wiremu. Me tēnei o tātou nei kai karakia me wāna nei mahi ki te tautoko ki te aki a tātou nei i tēnei rangi. E nei te mihi ki a koutou hoki e haere mai ā tinana, ā kanohi ki te kiti e tēnei rā tino hōhonu, tino hirahira kia tātou te iwi, tangata whenua, tumutumu, tangata whenua o tēnei wāhi o tātou nei o Aotearoa New Zealand. Oke nei mahi ki te haka takoto te kaupapa nei o ngā ture o te kīngi Wiremu i mua te aroaro o ngā prehimana me ngā kōti ārohe me te kōti teitei hoki. Kia mua i o rātou, kei tonu mātou, ki te ārihi tēnei kaupapa, i roto i a mātou nei āhuatanga, ka hore kei roto i te tamariki tanga, kuputātū tātou i tērā i roto i ngā tiriti i te hakapūtanga. Ko tātou nei, i tino honore ki te tū, ki te kōrero, ki te mahi, wēnei mahi, i runga te tika, te pono, te āroha me te rangi Māori. Tēnei tōku nei tūmanako, ke haere tātou i pērā, tainoa mai te timatanga, ki te tutukitanga, o tēnei kaupapa i tēnei rā. Mihi ana ki awa tātou nei kara, i muri, ke runga tēnei tēku o tātou nei. Ko tēnei te āhuatanga i kite e tātou te huarahi tika o tātou a tangata whenua me ngā whānau haku o nutiriti a te ho puta no mwana mai aki. Kore hau hiani ki kume tōro wēnei ngā kōrero i nā e tunu nei. Ko te mea kē i tika ana ke haere ngā kaupapa nei, i runga te rangi Māori. Huri rauna ki ngā koko ngā te whare. Tēnā koutou.
Ah, 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 ah John Roman started
with the writ warrant here to seize his property. He's already sold his $20 million property in town now. He bolted. He finished working with the Prime Minister until his time was up because he got caught for $13 million and he ain't going to get away with it because he's gone to good Europe and everybody else around the world. He's the bank mastermind and this is the bank player title holder of all of this. So we're going to exercise our jurisdiction, authority and mana inside that place today. So Bundy, all you have to do now is, as a prosecutor, if you're the policeman, he's going to be the police officer to go after anybody I name or anybody that takes over from me to this job once you get the hang of it. So then I get up and pass it over to Hiriwini to enforce from this court, because he's the judge, the British judge here, the native British judge, to make the final say. He will bang the bench like that. And this is an open court. It has no bar, it has no dock to put anybody in. This is from now on. We don't need, because we are the ship on dry land, we don't need a dock and a bar, like the normal courts. And that's their problem. They're not here today, they will be in the future, because we have 2-hour cases straight to Britain online. We don't have to, all the courts now you'll recognise that they're using video in the court setting because of all the protests outside the courts and all the extra police they have put on when somebody convicted and brought to the court. There's a whole commotion going on down the street. Not anymore, they use video because it's quicker. In 2 hours, we'll have this case all over. They'll make a ruling by default that John Key didn't turn up. Then the Paramount Chief will order the British military to go after them anywhere in the world. That's how it works, folks. And I'm glad you are here to witness it because you made the effort to get here. But it's on record. You'll lock yourself on this day as being, I was there to see this happen. And it's frozen in time, and we don't look back, we go straight ahead, straight to the mainstream with a big outfit on the back of us, no more fair. Okay, Bundy, we'll finish John Key off this.
Good, good, John. For the record, can we have this on the record? That we've called out John Key. Is John Key present? Is John Key present?
No.
Okay, let the record and put it on the official record that John Key did not turn up. Okay? For the note.
Yes. Thank you. I'm glad I got the old stalwart. My son Danny's another one. We've been with this a long time. So this is our call. This is our day. And we're going to push this lock forward with confidence. But it's
sure.
Kia ora tātou. E te kāna ki ai tū. Hono kaha ki te taha o tātou nei. Matua i te rangi a io kia manaaki ki a mātou nei. Kōti i tēnei rā. E raro i te tūranga. E huaina i rungi a hauna i te rāna. I te whakatakoto e ture, i runga i tēnei o tātou nei tangata, te premier o ngā Tauki Muri, ko John Key tēnā, ko te kaupapa nei i kororo Tira, i tēnei o tātou nei rangatira, a John Wano. Ka ore a John Key i puta mai i tēnei kōti i tēnei rā, i tika ana, kia mahi tēnei mahi i runga i āia, ki te hapa hokia mai ngā ahuru whenua me ngā kaitara i pāna ki tātou, ngā whānau, ngā hapu, ngā hapa tupuranga ki te haere mai. Kia hokohoki au mai ngā taonga kia tātou. I roi te marumaru o te whakamininga me ngā āriki. I tika ana, kia mea mai, kia John Key, kia hokohoki au mai, wēnei taonga katoa, mō tātou whakatupuranga me ngā whānau hapū, ngā iwi me rātou mā ki te haere mai, kia tātou. Hei painga mō rātou, tēnei oku nei tū, oku nei kōrero i tēnei rā, kia koutou, kia whakatakoto nei, tēnei kaupapa, i runga ia John Key, mā eia i whakautumia wēnei ngā kōrero o tātou te te pūnei, i mua te aroaro o te ao me koutou ngā whānau hapuiwi ngā rauranga tiramā. Hoi nāno, kei te otu i oku nei mahi i konei, ki te putātu ngā kōrero nei, ki iaia, kia John Key, nā, kia manahia oku nei kōrero i tēnei wā, i tikāna kia. Hara mai te toki, hau i e, hui e, hai. Kutu tuki tēnei kaupapa i roti e tātou i tēnei rā. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, e te kaihaka wā, kia koe te hakalongo ana tēnei nā kaupapa e whakatakoto i hei a tātou i tēnei rā. Kia koe te rangatira mānahi, kia koe te tua hene, kia koe te mihi ana ki tō mahi ki te kakuhia wana nā kōrero. Tēnā koe, me koe hoki, John, o tūtuki oku nei wahanga, mō tēnei kaupapa, mō tēnei wahanga. Koe nāna hurirana, hurirana te parei, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, hekti rā.
Kā te ora mai nō tātou, me whakapākei mea tūtuki oku nei kōrero te rāna. My name is Selwyn Clark, which is a straw man's name. My real name is Hiruini Kaka. And so today you heard the reply. John Key had been ordered to attend this court. He has not. So therefore, the attention then has been turned to us to rule and to state what must be done with John Key. So today I order the Royal New Zealand Army, the Royal Navy, the Royal Air Force, and the British Army place John Key under arrest and bring him to justice and clear this court. So I do this on behalf of those of my comrades, the 28th Battalion, and all their partners and their grandchildren on their behalf as well as the married people of this country. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost, I declare John Key under arrest today.
Thank you. I'm going to read out the rest of the list and we'll treat them all as one of each of the defendants to what I've been accusing for many years online, which is admissible evidence in any court, and in particular the Admiralty Court in London, High Court, and also the Magistrate Court in Edinburgh and Westminster. So I'm going to read out the rest of the defendants, the people I accused of fraud, defrauding the public of the newsroom, but in particular defrauding the Paramount Chiefs as to commercial landowners. Today, they shall be commercial landowners. That means equal to anybody else who says they're commercial landowners. But they have overriding titles over any other title below the king's title. So that's a learning experience for you and the public watching around the world, because they are affected by the same Queen's Bench Court title, and the King's Bench prevails when there is a fault or a justice system in New Zealand that cannot handle us anymore. They have no power to overcome an original native grand jury trial magistrate court. Now, here are the names. I'm going to read about all the names and we'll continue right through them, 23 of them, which won't take too long. We're just about at the end of our hearing. First defendant, we've been through just now, from the Hongi, theft of St. Patrick's 8-point star. You'll notice that Hongi came back from Australia. He's an Australian citizen now. And he's cleared out his property, cleared out all his wealth here, and no longer here. No longer any interest in New Zealand after he has damaged the whole economy, the whole business, the banks, the everybody, now in New Zealand. He has liable in New Zealand. And I've got that on my mind. They've got a bill coming for everything he touched and what he has used the Queen as a head of state when there's no head of state here in New Zealand. She's a private person, and she's gone into the EU Parliament as a conflict of interest against us. Very seventh defendant, HM Treasury London. Eighth defendant, Awaroa Bank, that's our original bank in Helensville. The legal, which went into the League of Nations, then it went into the United Nations, and ended up in the World Bank. That actually belongs to us. Ninth defendant, the BNZ Bank, that's funneled the money out here to London. They bankrupted the Awaroa Bank, by the way. 10th defendant, New Zealand Governor General Patsy Reddy. 11th defendant, ex-Governor General Jerry Matapai Andrews. He's the ambassador to New Zealand in Britain. That's filling in for the vacant Queen that's gone to the EU Parliament to fill their monarchy to make it look real, which is not. We're going to do something about that. She has no real interest in Maori anymore. That's the end. She might look like it, but it's not really. 15th defendant, Pope Francis Bergoglio. You can see all that happening, all the pedophilia and all the rest. 15th defendant, Donald Trump, Philippines gold property of Moai Crown King Queen Victoria Trust. Now, Queen Victoria Trust on this side of Georgie Dog, that's her dog, to chase after that. But I'll put on right after that. 16th defendant, Pope Adolfo Nicholas Patron, Black Pope, then back then, 2008. 18th defendant, Hillary Clinton. 19th defendant, Helen Clark, also TV, Elizabeth, Charlie Newsom. 20th, I was writing that in Parliament of Wellington, with our own claim and Moai Manukau's claim, 5-1-1. So I was 1 out of 300 out of 3,000 that went to the Parliament. So I know a thing or two about the Parliament. 20th of defendant, Prime Minister Bill English, book New Zealand Portal Seabed Act 2004, and continuation of corporate piracy treaties and legacy. The Whakamanea Paramount Chief's Native Grand Jury Trial Magistrate Court ordered the High Court and the District Courts of Auckland, New Zealand, and CID New Zealand Police need to stand down while the Paramount Chief's Sheriff Debt Collector seizes the scheduled list of land back into the Paramount Chief's Whakamanea Admiralty Private Contract Commercial Land Ownership with a writ of execution from the Waitangi Moriori and other authorised Moriori King's Bench Native Court Judge. So, Willie Tatum and OMABR was in the Waitangi Moriori that they didn't think I would get for this Native Magistrate Court. They said, we can't stop you. I said, no, it's my carvings in there from 93. And King said, oh, no, they can't stop him. So that's how we managed to get into that Moriori against all the odds. We got up onto One Tree Hill against all the odds to put up the plaque I was going to bring today, but I didn't bring it. Carpet and the giant of Waikato plaque that made him to a footpath up there. That's just another offence. And then you got Inumata, where the dug out 183 ancestors of Mohi Manukau and threw them in the container and said, here's your ancestors. And so these are just some of the horror things, Parihaka and everything up north. Those are complaints on this side to put into this side. And what my job is to write a paragraph on what happened now, right up to 970 million trees turning down. No. And that's weak. No one's saying a thing. When there's silence in the court, that's an admission of guilt. And we're treating all these cases today as guilty, as charged. In the video, the YouTube video, as fact-cited evidence, and we're studying these documents today, three of them, to take to the police to stand down, and to the district court, Auckland district court, to stand down, and to the lawyer, the QC's, Yutai Choi, South Korea, to stand, to make them force the landowner to off the land and leave the tenants there. We have managed to go straight in and take over the business and keep it going. But the people that got in the way of the contract, they know how contracts work. This is no different a contract as any other contract. That's why we have registered companies, trust of registered companies, straight to business. And not here. We don't use here because they have broken their own laws. The Crimes Act 1961 and Crimes Act 1951, any time over. Now, I'll just finish the book. And duty enforcement officers to recover the debts owed to the sheriff creditor back into the Moai Crown King William IV Trust through the King's Bench Native Magistrate Court in New Zealand and Commonwealth countries within the 250 countries to which the Magistrate Court and into the High Court of England in London, UK, if the New Zealand Crown Government agent stamp out with our King's Bench Admiralty flag, seal, authority, jurisdiction, court, Director of London, Trinity, Fire Crown, Waitangi, Moriori, King's Bench, Native Court, and annex invoice company to Moriori King William IV Trust through the British Royal Navy Military Native Land Church and seizure property and control of it of warrant for the new Fulton private contract against John Key and others of names and ID cards today. Annex has invoiced 970 million trillion download. Record debt in Britain, UK and New Zealand, account 77 Cook Street arrest warrant, enforced financial martial law on James Pierce Brown, Simon Brent Brown, property, proprietor of landowners, is this bill levying debt over their land and investment interests, hidden corporate and private trust account property land interests, entirely plus £1 trillion a day for non-performance on their deposit, private contract, and my grandchildren for trust, creditor, shared through annex invoice. 2.715 billion, that's just that land off. So we're going blanket right through the world on a one fixed value against the pound note. We're putting value in the pound note by fraud, business, and by tidal energy, turbine, hydrogen production as being ready to implement that as well. So more resources up goes the share. You can expect a 3-to-1 share return value on just the tidal energy. And this is a fraud business, it's big business at the present time. That's happening right in front of us today. So with that, I have read the names out. I'll leave it to Bundy, to he's the enforcer, and Henry, the judge of the day, the Paramount Chief Justice, that's his proper title, Paramount Chief Justice, Native Grand Jury Magistrate Court Judge. Manahi is the head of the native magistrate Grand Jury Trial Court, and Manahi is the justice of the peace. You need a justice of the peace on the legal side to convert the laws from a Queen's Bench Court into a King's Bench Court transition. So there's an act to change over one title to the other. We're seizing a Lynn title in the New South Wales monarchy sovereignty into their own Paramount Chief's own sovereignty, with the King's sovereignty I'm handling in England with his coat of arms, and the coat of arms of Rogan and Cosgrove, you'll see in the book here. I'm that family there in Belfast, straight to here, Ulster, from Ulster to Ulster. And that's political today. That's right up the top today with Theresa May, and the DUP party is where I'm going straight into the system with this title. They're waiting for this flag to put up to save Britain from the plunder of the Rothschild bank. They tried to shoot out everybody to buy the pound note. Well, this pound note will bankrupt that one and bankrupt anybody that's tampering around between Bundy and these guys and the British Royal Navy, First Lord and King, Sir Philip Jones. That's our partner, the legal partner, not Parliament. Those two that are the partner. The British gets off his ship and puts his flag up. That's really what it is. And our flag is the receipt of that contract. It is a living document of a valid, legal, legitimate, private contract, nobody's business to inquire in our figures and the way we write. We have the legal right to go straight into King George III, Acts of Parliament that included the 1694 Bank of England Act. He created the Bank of England Acts. He created the Pound Note Acts of Westminster Parliament. And he created the 8-point star, St. Patrick's Municipality. And everyone's claiming the St. Patrick's Order except us. We have the right on this flag to claim that purpose, because our kings put the titles together. And that's the good news. I wanted to let you know that we are that 8-point star and all its inheritance and fortunes right through the world where they've used this flag. We are saying they've used it for fraudulent means, for their own financial investment interest against the financial interest, investment interest of the Paramount Chiefs of this country and all other native countries in the world, following and waiting. They were waiting for Maori. No, you've got to wait for the Moai and its memorials. The Maori memorials have been made up by the Crown Corporation of New Zealand and New South Wales. This one is real. The Moai is real. You've got that memorial, you've got King William Memorial, you've got the flag, you've got chiefs, you've got those two chiefs. What more do you want? What more do you want? You've got more than enough to make a ship sink and go past. So, nō reira, tēnā koutou katoa.
Kata, e mahi ana a rātou nei mahi. E tautokana au a kōrero nei o John, i runga tēnei o tātou nei kara. Me o mātou nei tino rangatirakana. E mea mai a hau, kia rātou, kia whakahokia mai, kia whenua, me ngā taonga i roto i a rātou nei ringa-ringa, kia tātou nei, ngā āriki, ngā tino rangatira, me te whakaminina, wene ngā taonga. E naia tunu nei. Tēnei oku nei kōrero, e tūake nei i raro i te marumaru o Ionga Mano, kia tukuna wenei na kōrero, i runga te awa, te pono, te tika, te rangi māri. Kuri rauna, kuri rauna te pare. Tēnā koutou, Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa.
Kia ora. You are the governor of the Bloodline court in Surname, the pioneer to it, the Kumotata, the Moai of the Bloodline, Whareherehere, and Surname. I know the Moai of the Bloodline court, to hear the memory. When they took it, Mana he to that thing, Misa, Mana he to that thing, Bra, Kapil, Koyo, Kikoni Hoki to say, Toko Hoki Masu, Kai Tui, Mana he, when I Masu, Yoki, Yoki here, Kai Hoki to Mutgo, of course, he made. Porque o mapa é muito bom mostrado, o mostra tanto, é tão bom também, mapa, a gente não, a vida, na hora, na hora que o era mais coisa, tanto mais coisa de se morar este trabalho, é a licorna que o mapa de hoje do trabalho, a vida. Kawe me hoki ko mātu me iehe, kia mauri atu ki John Key koni. Nā, I ka kore a pito, u karanaku ki mātu ki ngā hoia o Ingarangi, ki ngā hoia o koni. Kia mauhere nie hongi te tangatu mei a John Key. I am going to be a little bit of a little bit of a little bit of a little bit of a John, when I was in the morning, I was in the doctorate of which the family.
That concludes the court today. The judge has spoken. Our Paramount Justice, Chief Justice. Hiruini Karaka has concluded the court hearing today. For the record, and all those people who are watching around the world, it's been made public today. For the record, to the British Westminster government, that we have now concluded an official. Legal and legitimate native magistrate court hearing here in Auckland, New Zealand. That now we take action against perpetrators of our land from what it is, and to be held accountable, backdated, right back to 1820, inclusive of all those years as the whānau, hapū, and other New Zealanders shall decide what should be done. It's not my call. I'm there to take our representation to Britain and live there, and I'm seeing them now again, but I want to go there to make a presence of just what has been missing all these years, to make it formal and real in the flesh and blood. That the changes that are evident now with the New World Order, this flag, by the way, is the New World Order, that they're trying to fashion themselves around the flag and get rid of the Admiralty and get rid of us. So we are having the last stand here, 8 hours, 8 points, to make a stand before they demolish the whole monarchy system. that's what's coming to now, that the Queen is frightened to abdicate, because we already have a king. King Ernest Augustus the Fifth is the reigning monarch that is on the Dutch bloodline to this flag and its origin. And his son, Prince Regent Ernest Augustus, 33 years old, and the King of Britain, UK, Hanover, and Oceanism now, today, cannot be changed because Salic law forbids women succeeding to the throne under a king's law. So we are holding up the law until that king is put on the throne and hold him as our partner. And that's what I'm going to put him on the throne to be crown our chief, and to make our legacy real for the first time. So that, people, you're here by design, that you're part of that historic change when we stop the video and take a blueprint of now ahead. We now have a straight path. Children will know where they come from. That's our first priority in policy with the Moai Crown, King William IV Trust. And we're putting those two powerful memorials together, and everybody in the world is part of that, including Maori. They have their own way of doing things, but I'm saying, on a whole, they use Moai to take themselves around the world and to assume that they are the rightful owner when you are. So I'm just going to take some quick things now that we have completed. I'm noticing on the table there, we're going to finish. Keep the money, take the votes out, and thought hearing off. Thank you very much. And we can have a question session afterwards. We're going to do the signing afterwards. And then we're going down to the deliver the documents.
Mira e tata ni. Ite heke na roi ma. Ite heke na ho. O tata ni. Mātua. O tata ni tūta. Koe ni rā pēa te huarahi. I huarahi tika. Huarahi pono. O tata. E iwi iti, engari te tātou te mana, whakahoki mai te mana, te tātou anō. Tāo tātou tūpuna te mana i tāua wā, ore ki te miri miri atu. I nā mahi whakahirahira i tēnei haura i tēnei rā, te whakahoki a mai rā te mana. O a tātou tūpuna. Ehtea, mo te ahuki, te hāre tonu o tātou tamariki moko puna.
Mo te mora puna. O te kūte o kune i kono e kone, kia koe matua e mingi māru ka te mo tātou.
Thank you, me.
Tā tira, tua. A hoa ko te nā hoa. Nā tini me nā mano e kore tai mai te nera. Ka tai. Me ka tūtuki tēne kaupapa ka tai. Ki pai ana te mana. A te wā. Ngare me tuku atu ke tō tātō kai hana. Nāna te inoi whakamutunga. Me te ki kōrero whakamutunga. Mō tātō kai. Mai te ika, mai au te aroa ki te wai pārnama, whakawhiti atu rā ki te whare kauri, a re kōmu. O ku whanaua o reira o te Moriori. O awa taha, mi kawana ki a koe. Nā, tōpito o tēnei, parihaka. Ka hoki nā mahumaha. E nā pakanga e whaka, tuanana te kāwana na Aotearoa nā whakanga whakamaumahara. Kare nā rātou e ne whakanga, nā tātou te. Taka pūra ke te hume te ua te kai māwaru o ake tōpa. Koera te rā, te tuanana tātou tīne o tūnā kara. O tō tātou tīno rana tira, tāngu. Ngari he tia. Me wāhi watu te rā, o tātou whakamaruahara mo nā whakanga mo te Eastern Waitangi. Kare huki e kua rā whakawātea. Ngari, a te wā. Nore kia tau te rangi māli e rāna tūanu e te tātou whare ke roto e kite.
Native Magistrate Court with Captain James Reid Clendon, with Tahitian Native Paramount Chief Pomare II, and Moriori Native Paramount Chief Whareherehere Manukau, 1830 to 1868. And swear an oath of office to the Moai, Earth, God, Spirit statue standing in Queen Elizabeth II Great Court, London, France, Belgium, Auckland, Dunedin, Washington DC, New York, Singapore, San Diego, Chile, that the matters herein are true, certain, and correct as contained within this native Te Hunga Waka Marae House of Newton, Paramount Chief. The Moai Crown King William IV Trust Company cited fact, evidence, witness, YouTube video spoken in the flesh and blood, me and Paramount Chief, live man amongst other live living men and women gathered here today, Friday the 29th September 2007, to witness to the world at large how very much alive we are, all making a legacy in a number of written affidavits of truth and fact. I'm herein stating the truth, the whole truth, and not just the truth, so help me God. These truths stand as fact until another can provide the material and physical evidence to say to the contrary. Four, that I fully and completely understand before any charges can be brought, it must be firstly proved by presenting the material evidence to support the fact that the charges are valid and have substance that can be shown to have material physical substance as a foundation in fact. And then we go on from Exhibit A, formal challenge to the presumptions of law. A presumption is something that is presumed to be true, and as a presumption, then there is not only a need for a formal challenge to that presumption to dismiss that presumption until the physical and material evidence can be presented to support that presumption shall be heard today against the accused criminals, names, photographs, and natural man and woman identified publicly over a period of time has automatically defaulted in a no response, no show, no rebuttal, silent admission of a guilty as charged criminal case. But, I'm saying pardon. And as a consequence of non-performance in a private contract by default, charges are now enforced under the 13th Paramount Chiefs 1834 Whakameninga, British side, Moai Crown, King William IV Trust, the company here, bank creditors through our Auckland Native Magistrate Court here today, Paramount Chief, British Settlement Justice, Joan Clark, and Enforcement Officer, Paramount Chief Judge Bundy Waitai, and Paramount Chief JP, Justice of the Peace, Lawmaker, Moriori, Legal Representative to Westminster Magistrate Court, Law, Office, me, as Paramount Chief Wanikahi Wano, Surrogate King William III, and Surrogate King William IV, Surrogate King George III, and Surrogate King George IV, and Surrogate St. Patrick's Belfast, and Surrogate St. Mary's Tiddy, and Edinburgh, Scotland, Holy Well. Surrogate Moai Crown statue in Dunedin and London, Brussels, France, New York, Washington DC, included on our original New South Wales region 1835, Declaration of Independence, Whakamanika, his Ariki, King Tauroa, Tūnakora, Jim Wikotu, and the late edition participants, Uri Keita, and forever Epiha, George Job, for Tūnakora, and Alfred Mitchell, original 1835 VOI Confederation. So that's as far as I want to go, because it goes on to Exhibit B and some more statements of fact cited for this court hearing. Now, I want to bring up the first case with John Key, which has already gone through, and we are holding him to account for the Panama Papers, bank fraud, and also for the $30 million that he took from the taxpayers here and gave to Helena Clinton for her terrorist operation. So those have been swept under the carpet, but most of all, John Key was instrumental in the TPPA to form an alliance against us to take this country over by threatening to change our flag until that failed, and also he was instrumental in the Moai statue in Carter Farms with the rugby, the New Zealand All Blacks. They used the Moai statue to come out of the ground to get rid of the Moai. And so these are our offences against us that we hold them accountable for being a threat against our national investment bank interests and the interests of New Zealanders at the same time. They are losing as well. So it's a lost situation when those private corporations and the NZ Invest Limited Company in Mahuhu Crescent on the waterfront, they have 82 private companies. The Crown is running, the government, I'm saying, the Crown in Wellington, and they are taking the money for themselves. The police themselves and the CID have 12 companies of their own. That's one of them is who have arrested me and using my birth certificate that I cited against them, using that from citing this birth certificate and ticketing. So they are still in this writ warrant to seize the land that is fraudulent on the land transaction from one original land title. And they left out the Manukau name on the title, the Lynn's New South Wales title, failed twice to register an interest, not a financial interest, but an interest in land under the Land Act, the 1954 Native Land Act. They're supposed to put any name on the title, and you'll know that the Manukau, the Moai, the Parapara, and Waikai, those are original names that should be on these titles, and they've elected to leave them out. This was the Australian New South Wales government in Wellington have fashioned their own titles to leave these names off. And so that's what this court hearing. We have the legal right to seize the land because of a bad title. And myself in the United States should know that. So all the offences that John Key is inside this was 2012, the Maori government put this together as a declaration of war against this country. It is a declaration against the pirates who are running their businesses inside the churches here and inside the Parliament in Wellington. And there's no difference from Winston Peters being the Deputy Prime Minister from now with the National Party. They've won the election, and he's got his hand in the pot as well. So we are addressing those features of their authority and by the time putting the Paramount Chief where they should be, administering their own land for the first time. So I'm just calling John Key to this court hearing today. He has had enough warning, and because he's not here, then we're going to call on the writ warrant to seize his property and have him arrested today. This, I'm the registrar with the list of names. We are only putting three names today, and the rest are for the for later. We're just going to do three cases, two cases, with John Key and the landowners of Cook Street. That's been long running since 2008, when I first started that with Moriori. He won his land. And so that's all. We can do those other cases. This is a test model case. It had its first time with the Maori UN marshals, and that failed miserably. But my barrister used my cited evidence to get them off, but let me out of the court hearing. So that hence the reason why we are taking him to court here and send it to Britain to sort out. We can initially seize the property ourselves. We're going to use you, Tai Choi lawyer, and tie him into the business side of the Moai tidal turbine projects that's going worldwide at the moment. And that's been set up since 2008 as well. It started off in Kaipara Harbour, and now it's in Scotland and East Cape and Ranfurly Bank, ready to go. So that belongs to you, people, as being in shareholding in this business, commercial business here in Auckland. We have the Moai Crown as one business. We have Moai, we have the Moai King William IV Trust that all the funding from seas land goes into, and that's consolidated right through the 250 countries in the world who join us and gets the numbers. We need more numbers than a few now. So that's one way of doing that. And we have the Whakamininga Trust. That's the other trust here. This is set up in this Moai Crown business, straight to England. They recognise us as being such. And so that's the creditor from this Moai Crown in Britain. So I'll go and administer there, and they administer the Whakamininga Crown, which is another entity, and it runs off from there to administer all the funds that go to the Maori government or any other organisation that becomes a member on this side. So there's a £25 joining fee, one off, that's it, for 1 billion shares in each country, ready to go. So that's going to be run from a world stage here, because of the flag standing here, where the flag is. We're taking the flag from Britain first, and then to other countries after that. So, John King, is he here today? Yeah. No, he's not here. He hasn't walked in because he's been notified. So now, I leave it to Bundy, because he will, as a normal case, he's prosecutor, to prosecute John King today. I'm the register to read the names out, and he will make a ruling. Supposed to be her Maori partner on this side, but worst of all, she has damaged our ship of admiralty on the King's side and the government's side on this side. So I'll finish off what I've accused them of. Theft of this 8-point star, because we're going to be wearing it. And they've got a problem because there's two of us wearing it. The Queen's side and the Rothschild banks, and this side, the Paramount chiefs and the King. Still there in a contract that no one can tamper with or evidence or interfere with its processes from today. And that was Cook Street. They tampered, the police tampered, the CIB tampered with the two-party contract I had with the two landowners, and they've got in trouble. The King will sort that out in a valid future. So, theft of the 8-point star on our flag for their own private needs and wants, 1834 declaration of war flag against pirates and thugs like him, and the rest of New Zealand Crown Corporation, fraud, corrupted courts, trading bank wall, head of our Queen Victoria Trust, Queen Elizabeth II no longer, the seal of the courts of illegitimate New Zealand laws. So one of the things I said to the judge when I went out of prison and in front of him, I said, you got no seal of your court, you got no seal in Westminster, you got no seal at all of authority. So that's what won my case. Just uttering those words to him with this flag. You'll notice I'm wearing the coat of arms, King William IV, the Moai statue here, the stamp here of the Moai. This is your, this is who you are, as on the document, legal on any document to make it work. That memorial, this stamp, is the two chiefs, Paramount Chiefs Hongi, Hika, and Tira, Waikato, Whareherehere, Manukau, and Jenny Clendon, and also King William and the flag. That's those two most powerful flags that will drive these documents and this magistrate court right through the world. And it belongs to you. Okay, so you can expect something to happen after the day. I can assure you, I've done my homework. And these Paramount Chiefs pick it up quick. This guy was a 19-year-old brain. I don't know how he does it. He knows what's happening here. The second defendant, James Pierce Brown and Simon Rent Roundtree, 77 Cook Street, last chance to rebut these legal allegations against you both, lost the case with the CIB News and Police tampering. In this case, you cannot win. You liable all the entire police force and court judges, conveyancing lawyers, barristers, solicitors, parliament ministers of the Crown of New Zealand. There's James Pierce Brown and Simon Brent Roundtree, the owners of 77 Cook Street, Auckland, in this court today to face the chief, the commercial landowners. Does anybody see those two here?
No.
Present?
Okay.
Are they?
No, they're not.
So from here on, I'll save all the rest and go straight through because none of them is going to turn up. But those two landowners will make a ruling on it with Bundy and Terewini after. I'll just read the rest of it and that'll be the finish. But they'll follow in the same pattern from those after the main two, the defendants of that Cook Street property, we're going to see back into the King's Bench Native Grand Jury Court and to the Moai Crown King William Court Trust. It has to go into a trust, and from that trust, its portion of a length and breadth, longitude and latitude of New Zealand, as compared to the rest of the world, as being a portion of 250 countries' values worth of recovered lands and so forth. So I'm just saying, at the present time, we have 70% claimants, 70% of New Zealand country, versus 30% of the Queen's elite on this side, as a population. And the same formula is going to apply to Britain, to the world, 250 countries. 70% of the King's people have to claim or have claimed to all that recover, including Cook Street. The land, the Queen says she owns the land and all the wealth, that's just one. And this side is 30% of the population of the world, of 7.5 billion people, are debt. The Queen, Crown, Corporation, Rothschild, Bank, credit, are debt against the King's Bench Court. Credit. And the Whakamania is first credit here over the whole country. The whole country comes under one title. Many titles inside of one big title, inside a big title, world title. There's three titles. The small title, Cook Street, the bigger title, New Zealand and Pacific Island, because these two chiefs did away with the Whareherehere and Manukau, sold all possessions from Chatham or Rekohu. Okay, so Manahiji is not there. So, once again, 70% of what we recover from Cook Street gets divvied up in 200 countries in portions as per population and area of land, including we have 500 mile radius of New Zealand. Bundy has a 200 mile economic zone, so we'll spread that further out. And its title as against the whole rest of the world. We're talking world here with 8-point star, and it's their 8-point star without equal star that has the overruling authority of the king. So I'll just carry on now.
Excuse me, John. Just before we carry on, because of the second defendant, James Brown, Has James Brown been notified of this hearing?
Yeah.
Just so the record knows.
Yeah.
Okay, well, let the record know that for every defendant, can you just let the record know that they've actually been notified?
Let the record know that
they haven't attended.
Let the record know for every defendant.
Yeah, so that way we've got it on record.
Okay. Let the record know today that this is another one of a defaulted contract I had with those two landowners. Previous to that, since 2012, personal videos going into his office, their office, and if I
want. It might be James Brown.
Simon Brett Brown-Tree and James Pierce Brown have been notified 3 times by official letter from the letterhead of the companies here, and we do have registered companies here in Britain against any corporate company. We have Ngātua Aokea Limited, company in New Zealand, with 1 trillion shares, and Britain, the first of billion shares, as my Powerhouse Group Limited company registered there with the management team there already. We're ready to go there and take this up. So those corporate people is a long-standing Manukau title that they have taken it from the original Jamie Peters and the mortgage that he had a mortgage in sale, and before that Doug Rickard Bell, property developer of the Gulf Harbour. They were both property developers here and on the waterfront, and I've been in real estate for a long time to know that. And they came from Sydney, Australia. So those titles have been well informed all the way through. It's got a history from this Moai that we signed. All these documents are here. And taken to Tiki Moai and signed again with that Cook Street as being a big offender. That's the Crown's business in Auckland, New Zealand, is where they're hiding everything inside that Mahuhu prison, NZ Invest. New Zealand Intuition New Zealand Limited, and also, worst of all, Waitangi National Trust is the Queen's business. These are the private corporations that are wrecking it for you, and I'm there to pull the power back into the bank. They are usurping it. I must say, while I'm here at this point, that John Key came back to fashion the New Zealand Wars on the 28th of October, the Declaration of Independence Day, for themselves and Peter Parodi to take this flag because we're not using it. And that's why they've got it in the museum in down in Wellington, and here in on tree ground, they're paid to go see the old land. And so we are seizing the land there, in this red warren, seizing the land, and Kingy's supposed to be doing that just me, but he's walked out by the other way. And also Titi Landlocked. I've got all the titles for that, the original title, the British title. So, now, we're going to move on. James Pierce Brown and Simon Brent Brown, we will seize their property this time and have them arrested. So, Bundy can sort that out after. I'll just read the rest of the names and that'll be the conclusion of this court hearing. That was the second defendant. The third defendant, Te Tumutumu Whairua Trust, married name, fourth, cannot produce an original Moriori Manukau land title versus the Manukau company, that's Manahi, Manukau company that put that together with Kerawaitiko Whareherehere Manukau in Britain. Title, private contract between King George IV in 1820 to 1830, brother King William IV, 1830 to 20th March 1834, founding of New Zealand as a British, King William IV, 8-point star of St. Patrick, to the Four Corners of the Globe Municipalities Act and the Bank of England Act 1694, and the Imperials Act of the Pound Note, which we hold in the Moai Crown, Pound Note currency in ANZ Bank, Auckland, during Sir Manager. We have the Pound Note already in this. All these Pound Notes are here in this book. Third defendant is Queen Elizabeth II, New Zealand Police and New Zealand Navy. Fourth defendant, Queen Victoria Trust, the trustees, Queen Elizabeth II, Prince Andrew, and Imelda Marcos in Spain. Fifth defendant, Intuition Museum Limited.
Now, the only children that lost a lot because of the situation that we let go. And from now on, don't think this is a one-off situation. It is not a one-off situation. And as far as we're it's on keep until we get to the real satisfaction of answers that we need. We need answers and we need results. And so when we came home from the war in 1946, January, the colonel who was then ready to be dismissed, the whole of America took him. And he said to us, one last order I give to you. Go back to your mountains, go back to your morale, go back to your people and be the relative that you are. To 8 battalion, dismiss. Well, the battalion is all gone now. There's only 2 of us left. And so, what I say, if it's the last thing I'm going to do, I'm going to carry out that order. And I hope that it carries on after I'm gone. I've been the youngest fellow in the battalion. I just turned 19 the other day. And so don't be disheartened if they don't turn up. You'll all be on record. If they don't turn up, you'll be on record. And you'll have someone we're going to be talking to. And it doesn't matter if they set up or not. We're going to hold these courts until such time as our people are satisfied with the privileges in one
country. Before I start, I just want to show you the Moai, Paramount Chief Moai, Tamati Manukau, Whakapapa. Here, he was a Freemason for 50 years in Helensburg. Now, I'll just say it this way, that the Awaroa Magistrate, Native Magistrate Court, was shifted from Okiato Magistrate Court up north, and they started off the Manukau title and seized all the titles with a writ warrant. And so we're doing the same thing again today. We're issuing a writ of control and possession and property seizure warrant today, this book. There's 106 pages. And we're doing exactly what they did back then, when they blew the place up in Purarareka and took the title down to Kohimarama, and Bundy is going to look after that side of the government, that British government that came there. He can fashion it in the way, but I'll keep him on track because I've got all those documents right here. The magistrate court that I have in its full entirety is all these books you see here, and they go into that briefcase over there. That's a magistrate court, portable, that can operate courts anywhere in the world. And I'll be running around the world with that. And they have a shortened version, which is that. This is legal. This book is legal. It is the acts of King William IV, 7 years only, of acts, 1984 pages, and they are legal. You can pick any one of those, because we haven't touched the contract form with the King in England, and we've got to go there to change it, amend it, or leave it as it is. But I'm going there with the Paramount Chief to replace the Queen as the head of the trust on this side, and take over the trust that belonged to us, that where all that revenue has gone missing out of the King's Bench Court side. So they've helped themselves to the King's Bench Court and silenced the King. The King is no longer silent. They're awake and operating from today, legally on the Crown's business there in Auckland. So we have some competition now to match up to the plate, which we have the mouse to do it, the intelligence to do it, the Whakapapa to do it, and the titles to the land, the native titles, the original native titles, starting from here in 1840 with the Freemasons and the Manukau Chief. That's been hidden away, and they kept that magistrate court is a bank. It is a bank, portable bank. When the captain gets off his ship, he's got the bank.
in the ship tied up at the bell. In the four corners of the earth, the eight points are the municipality of this hat, the sheriff, can see the land. If you see somebody wearing that hat, there's only one of them. So anybody qualified to put that on their head can do the same as what we're just about to do. Okay, so we'll leave it to the lawyer. We'll go through the proper channels, how to seize land in the right way, commercial way, and a legal or formal way than protest or complaint from the public. So we're doing it. This Whakapapa is the title. This is the native title that the British accepted. It's got the Rogans, the Manukau, and the Wānoa tied up in it. They married them to get the title from the East Coast and from the Kaikara and up north through their chief. So we're going to pass all this law up and leave it and carry on with who we are today. That's the main thing. Okay, so I just want to let you know this is in this book and we'll put that online. Well, it's online now. I'm going to go ahead with the court hearing now and you'll see Henry or Sheldon, his name on these documents is Sheldon Clark. As a Maori, he's Pedawin Karaka. But today, he shall be Sheldon Clark, the Magistrate Chief Justice, Paramount Chief Justice, from his ancestors that did all these work in the old days in Hokianga. So Hokianga features quite a lot in this history before it went to Russell, or Hokianga, and down into Auckland. So we're dealing with the live today title to Auckland and the Crown Court. So I'm going to go straight to the Auckland Native Grand Jury Magistrate Court, New Zealand. That's what we're calling it here. We keep the Moriori quite separate from it because I couldn't call it Te Unga Waka, but we use the Moriori based court hearings. This is a Moriori, and so this is the closest to One Tree Hill where this title is. And it is only just the title, it's not the everything of everything. You still have your own Whakapapa, and you don't have to follow this. The British follow it, and it's up here somewhere. The land still belongs to you, but in the commercial sense, we're taking that away from them and converting it back to the sons and daughters of the land today. So we can put that at rest. That's what I want to say about that. The spirit of this in their title on this side. Now, I'm going to do this. We have, I'm calling this hearing today of my role to go to England and for Bundy and Mahi and Whareherehere to administer the Crown land, the Moai Crown. We're talking about our own Crown and King William's Crown over there. King William's flag belongs to him, but we use its power because he gave it to us. Anybody else on this side is third party, and they've got a problem. Georgia picks up the third party problem. And this two party contract is still alive today. No one can cancel it. That's what I'm saying. So I'm going to start off with it. I'm not going to go right through all the pages. I'm just only going up to the exhibits because it can go on the exhibits of who is who, but I'm just going to read out so far and then I'll tell you whose names are going on hearing today. It reads here, affidavit of truth and statement fact, 29th day of September 2017. Affidavit of truth and statement of fact, number one, I, John Kawani Tahaki of the House of New Zealand, Paramount Chief, being the undersigned, do solemnly swear and declare and depose, two, that I am competent to state the matters herein and do take oath of the Moai Crown office here today, to swear, I swear an oath of office to Paramount Chief Hongi Hika, 1830, Kupalan, Tahitian, and Moriori, Tira, Waikato, Whareherehere, Manukau, 1820, and King George IV, 1820, time memorial. And I swear an oath of office to Dutchman, King William III, King George III, and his sons, King George IV, King Ernest Augustus I, and King William IV of Westminster Parliament, UK, England. And I swear an oath of office to my ancestral Patrick Church Order, Cosgrove Rogan, coat of arms in Belfast, Ulster, Northern Ireland, and my Wairua Uruta Tupuna in Tikitini, St. Mary's Church, 1831, linked to Belfast 8-point star of St. Patrick's, municipalities of the 1834 State of Emergency, flag sovereign authority given by King William IV to the Paramount Chief, which we inherit his fortunes and prized possessions by these his presence in our two-party private contract partnership. And I swear an oath of office to St. Mary's Church, Edinburgh, enshrined in the Holy Well, linked to our St. Mary's Church in Tikitini, and Whakapapa Native Magistrate Court, Hirohama, Mount Hikarangi, East Coast, to St. Mary's Church, Parnell, Auckland Sea, to Awaroa Native Magistrate Court, Helensville, to Okiato Native Magistrate Court, Kororarika, Russell Bay of Islands, direct to Westminster Magistrate Court, Paddington, Westminster City, UK, England, Sir Philip Jones, First Lord of the Sea, of King William IV, Sovereign Authority, Jurisdiction, and the 1834 Flag of Admiralty, Training Bank, Moai Crown Bank Magistrate Court Partnership. And I swear an oath of office to the 13 chiefs who formed the 1834 Whakamanga Flag.
Come on, come on. Here we go.
Shoot everyone.
It's the real Māori party. A real Māori party.
Māori party got no seats.
It's
alright. We've got all the seats.
You hit it when you get here. So now we're just signing the official documents.
Oh, kia ora, Papa Honey. One, I'd just like to ask you a few questions. How to met?
We're signing the writ of writ of control and possession of land and also King William IV. We'll do one at a time for the land next time. And this makes me
go ahead.
You hit it when you get there. So now we're just signing the official documents.
Oh, kia ora, Papa Honi. One, I'd just like to ask you a few questions. How to met?
We're signing the writ of control and possession of land and also King William IV. We'll do one at a time for the land next time. And this makes me
go ahead.
You hit it when you get there. So now we're just signing the official documents.
Oh, kia ora, Papa Honi. One, I'd just like to ask you a few questions. How to met?
We're signing writ of control and possession of land and also King William IV. We'll do one at a time for the land next time. And this makes me
go ahead.
You hit it when you get there. So now we're just signing the official documents.
Oh, kia ora, Papa Honi. One, I'd just like to ask you a few questions. How to met?
We're signing the writ of control and possession of land, and also King William IV. We'll do one at a time so we don't get mixed up. And this makes me
take the hat
take this one. You hit it when he gets here. So now we're just signing the official documents.
Oh, kia ora, Papa Honi. One, I'd just like to ask you a few questions. How to meet?
We're signing the writ of control and possession of land, and also King William the Fourth. We'll do one at a time so we don't get mixed up. And this makes me
take
this
one.
You hit it when he gets here. So now we're just signing the official documents.
Oh, kia ora, Papa Honi. One, I'd just like to ask you a few questions. How to meet?
We're signing the writ of control and possession of land, and also King William the Fourth. We'll do one at a time so we don't get mixed up. And this makes me
take the hat off.
Take this one. You hit it when he gets here. So now we're just signing the official documents.
Oh, kia ora, Papa Honi. One, I'd just like to ask you a few questions. How to meet?
We're signing the writ of control and possession of land, and also King William the Fourth. We'll do one at a time so we don't get mixed up. And this makes me
take the hat off.
Take this one. You hit it when he gets here. So now we're just signing the official documents.
Oh, kia ora, Papa Honi. One, I'd just like to ask you a few questions. How to meet?
We're signing the writ of control and possession of land, and also King William the Fourth. We'll do one at a time so we don't get mixed up. And this makes me
take the hat off.
Take this one. You hit it when he gets here. So now we're just signing the official documents.
Oh, kia ora, Papa Honi. One, I'd just like to ask you a few questions. How to meet?
We're signing the writ of control and possession of land, and also King William the Fourth. We'll do one at a time so we don't get mixed up. And this makes me
take the hat off.
Take this one. You hit it when he gets here. So now we're just signing the official documents.
Oh, kia ora, Papa Honi. One, I'd just like to ask you a few questions. How to meet?
We're signing the writ of control and possession of land, and also King William the Fourth. We'll do one at a time so we don't get mixed up. And this makes me
take the hat off.
Take this one.
Yeah.
You hit it when you get there. So now we're just signing the official documents.
Oh, kia ora, Papa Honi, I just like to ask you a few questions. How to meet?
We're signing the writ of control and possession of land and also King William the Fourth. We'll do one at a time for the next time. And this makes me
the
head
of
it. You hit it when you get there. So now we're just signing the official documents.
Oh, kia ora, Papa Honi, I just like to ask you a few questions. How to meet?
We're signing the writ of control and possession of land and also King William the Fourth. We'll do one at a time for the land next time. And this makes me
the head
of
it.
Thank you.